I played Patrick Dempsey's father on an episode of a CBS show called Once and Again, I think it was called. CeeLo Ward was in it, yeah. And but you never really saw me. He was kind of skitsy. And when he came to visit CeeLo's house, he was CeeLo's brother in the series. And she invited him for the holidays. And he came and stayed with them. And he was having schizophrenic attacks while he was at their house. She pulled him out of the institution he was in, brought him to the house. When he would have these schizophrenic attacks, his father would talk to him in his head, tell him he was no fucking good. He never was any good, never would be any good. And her mic's not working, thank God. So anyway, you saw me with a hat. You saw a shadow behind him. When he would have these attacks, you'd hear this voice, and the voice said bad things to him. And the woman who cast that show was involved in the casting for Saul 1. She remembered me. She knew a voice was involved with a little tape recorder, blah, blah, blah. And she brought me to visit with James Wan. And I sat with James. And I sat with James, and we talked, and I had read the script, and I had seen his 7-minute short, and I knew he could deliver the goods based on that 7-minute short. I thought it was very theatrical. So one, three guys locked in a room. You don't usually make movies about that. And I wanted to work with Danny Glover. And I thought if they shoot the last moment as well as they eventually did, it'll be a really amazing moment, because when I read the script, I had no idea that moment was coming. So I thought if they shoot it really well, it'll be a great moment. It'll be worth doing. It'll be worth lying on the floor for 2.5 weeks.
Which he did. That was him, live.
Right.
But dead.
Yeah.
Not really.
And Costas Mandalore was not yet born. He was still a figment of his mother's imagination down in Australia.